Okay, this is going to be a video on what not to do. It's been raining, it's been cold, sun came out today. So I'm riding Mr. T. Now, he was feeling bad for a while. He's got his oats back. He's feeling good. Last couple days I've come out here, he's been very resistant. He hasn't listened. He wants to try and run off. If I don't have a halter on him, normally he follows me. So he's been giving me all kind of signs of dominance and a lack of seeing me as a leadership. So what I did here is I saddled him up, and Buddy's in the tack room over there eating. He's around the corner. I'm going to show you where he's at. Now, Buddy, when I ride Mr. T, he gets excited. He wants to run and come and buck, and he likes to play, which makes Mr. T even harder to handle. So what I'm doing is I'm setting the horse and myself up to fail. It's muddy. It's wet. It's rainy. I'm getting on Mr. T. I haven't lunged him. I haven't established respect. I've done no groundwork. I haven't moved him. He's been resistance. I pulled some grass spurs out of him, and then I saddled him up. And this is what I, you know, people tell a horse, that horse is cold backed. You got to wear him out. Otherwise, you get on him when he's cold backed. I don't like that saying. I don't like having to wear my horse out before I get on him. But I do like my horse to respect me. And Mr. T's dropping his head, and he's being pretty good standing here. But as soon as I start moving, he's going to start talking and throwing his head to Buddy. And he's going to be very hard to handle. So I don't know what kind of filming I'm going to do, because handling him with one hand when he's like this is pretty tough. And again, I'm just riding him with a rope halter and a rope. Oh boy, Mr. T. But again, I'm setting him up and myself to fail. And I see people do this all the time. In the middle of winter, the sun comes out. Oh, what a great day. I'll go ride. Look, you get on your horse, and you're going to have your hands full. Mr. T wants to walk off there. I don't want him walking up. Come on, back up. Pay attention. So I want to establish a little bit of dominance there. Don't walk off without me. Now, he would be dancing, etc., if I wasn't controlling him. So I'm going to have to give him a lot more direction and a lot more control. Now, a lot of English riders are called, that's keeping him on the bit. You got to keep him on the bit. He has to know your control. Look, I want a loose rein. I want my horse to stand when I tell him to stand. And then I want to go back to a loose rein. And because I'm moving his camera to the left and everything, he's kind of like, you do what you want. It's okay, Mr. T. I'm just filming you. So he's ready to go. Now, Buddy's in that tack room over there. And as I come by and he sees that we're riding, he's going to come out like a bat out of hell, start bucking and walking. So here we go. Ain't no telling what's going to happen here, but if I end up on my butt, I'll still post it. Miss Buddy! So we're going to let Buddy see that we're riding. Buddy! Come on! You watch Buddy come out of here as soon as he thinks we're leaving. Here he comes. Come on. All right, we're going to go this way. Now it's muddy. Mr. T's head's very high. He's prancing. He ain't walking. Look at that head. Okay. Now, Buddy hasn't really got jacked up yet. Mr. T's trying to go around this water. So he's trying. Mr. T's trying to bring me to this gate over here. See him walking sideways? He's like, I want to go in the gate. Hear that honk? He's telling me, I don't want you riding me. I've been in the pasture. It's been cold. I finally feel good. Now you're going to throw a saddle on me. So he's giving me all these indications. I tell people, horses talk to you all the time. Mr. T's talking to me. He's telling me, I don't want to ride. I don't feel like this. You've only got one hand. You're filming. You're talking on that phone. You're not paying attention. My friend is over there running free. I want to be a horse. He's telling me all this stuff, but people get on their horse and they get around their friends, or they get around a barn and they want to show how they can cowboy or cowgirl up and get on a fresh horse and just ride it out of them. And then they end up either slipping, falling, getting hurt, getting a horse hurt, and then the horse learns a bad lesson. So we're going to walk Mr. T out over here. And then you're going to see Buddy kind of go, hey, where are you going? Look at him. He's prancing. I'm jumping. Look at him. He wants to run. If I let these reins go, me and Mr. T will be at a full run, because he is not respecting me at all. And the longer I let him do this, and then you watch, Buddy's going to come around this corner in a minute. I want to see. Because as soon as he sees us gone, hey, there he comes. Here comes problems. Now he's going to want to play. And Tanner's going to want to follow him. And I'm going to let him follow him. But I got to be careful. So Mr. T wants to run. I didn't tell him to run. He's honking. He's telling Buddy to run. Now he's snorting. Hear that? See? He doesn't want to walk. I don't like running him. You hear him snorting? I got these reins all tight. I'm holding him back. He's pulling and bracing. I'm going to run him into this fence right here. See, you need to stop. There. Okay? I couldn't stop him with the reins because he was too drawn on Buddy. And he's just so jacked up. And you know, somebody's going to want to look at this and go, man, that guy don't know how to ride. Look at that horse. He's just, look, I'm showing you what happens when you set your horse up to fail. Now, if I had two hands on this horse and I wasn't filming and I wasn't walking and Buddy was doing all this, I'd be controlling him. I'd be giving him direction. He's already jacked up. He's already breathing hard. I'm going to flex him and you can watch his nose. Hey, pay attention. He is ready to go. Now, Buddy's just like, hey, I'll wait over here and I'll eat until you're ready to run. Mr. T is, I can just feel the tension in his body and he's breathing. Again, he's been in pasture for a few weeks. It's been raining. It's been wet. All he's been doing is eating and staying warm. And then I come out here, saddle him up and get on him and expect him to be a perfect horse. Okay, it ain't going to happen. He is being pure horse, and it's irritating to me, and I get frustrated, and I know he can do better, and I know he should do better, but I've set him up to do all these things. I haven't given him good direction with two reins. I haven't, you know, not trying to ride, filming, and holding this camera. I've set him up to where he's going to come out here and show me that, hey, I don't have to listen. You don't have control over me. You're not giving me enough direction. You're too busy filming. You're only using one hand, so therefore I don't think you got control of me. And if I don't think you got control of me, then you know what? I'm going to do what I want to do. And he's not being mean. He's not being stubborn. He's not being angry. He's not out of control. A lot of people see me riding Mr. T like this, and they say, man, that horse is dangerous. He's uncontrollable. He's unpredictable. Well, he is a somewhat, I guess I'd say, a dangerous horse if you don't know what you're doing. And that's the problem. A lot of people who ride don't know what they're doing, so their horses get labeled as dangerous because they get hurt, because they get knocked down. I just noticed this wind's blowing out here, so hopefully you can be able to hear me. All right, we're going to go ahead and walk over here this way. And again, Mr. T is just, I mean, if you can see his shadow, his head's bobbing. His head's high. I'm going to turn him sideways so you can try to look at that head. That head's way. Look at him. He's trying to talk to Buddy. Look at him. He's trying to run. Look at him. He wants to run. I didn't tell him to run. I'm going to turn him. So you want to run? You can turn and run. So he's like, okay, I guess I'll turn. Maybe I don't want to run. So he kind of stopped, and I gave him that loose rein, and he just dropped his head, and he's going to have a snack. And I'm going to let him have a snack. As a matter of fact, I'm going to let go of the reins. And if he takes off, I'm going to reach out and grab those reins. You hear him blowing? That's frustration. Hear that? He's frustrated. Hear that? People go, oh, he's just blowing something out of... No. He is frustrated as hell right now. He's telling me, dude, you're bugging me. Why are you riding me? Why are you stopping me? I want to be eating with my buddy. I don't want you riding me. I just moved this thing right here, and he flinched. So I'm going to move it three or four more times. I don't want him flinching when something moves. And I ain't got the reins. Ain't nobody holding him back. My hands are all free. But he flinched when I did this, and I don't like that. No more than I like when I take my hat off, and I bang my hat on the side. He shouldn't be moving. Good boy, buddy. Take that poop. Keep that internals going. So, Mr. T is very frustrated right now. And again, I'm setting all this up. This is me. This isn't the horse. People see this horse, or they'll see me, and they'll blame the horse. You know, there's just some people out there that'll get on a horse backwards and face the butt and blame the horse for facing the wrong way. It's you. Everything you do with a horse is you. And the more you can do that, I'm going to try to get Mr. T to walk a little bit. But he ain't going to want to walk. Look at that head, boy. That head. Look at that prance. I didn't ask him to trot. That head's high. Look at that. He's pulling. Look at that head. Look at that head. He's like, you ain't paying attention to me. I'm going to run you into this fence. Oh, you want to run? Buddy, easy. Hey. See? I got to get that head turned. Because these horses out here started running. And he was like, oh, yeah, I'm free. Look out. Hang on. So I had to bend that head, flex that head, and get that. And trying to do that with one hand and hold his phone is cheating the horse. Because I'm not giving him good direction. I'm not showing him that I can control him. I'm off on my timing. I'm off on my release. And the horse feels all that. That's why when people get out and they ride their horse and they're on their iPod and they're listening to tunes or they're texting or they're talking to the trainer or they're looking at the trainer and listening to what they're saying and they're not paying attention to your horse. When you're riding your horse, you need to be paying attention to your horse, period. If you want to stop talking, you need to stop that horse have them face the direction you want, and then have them stand there. So while you're talking and everything, you're not giving the horse missed signals. Riding this horse, talking in this camera is unfair. It's not fair to Mr. T. And he's making all these mistakes. And you know, I could be saying stupid horse and crazy and he's out of control and he thinks he's a stunt. Look, Mr. T, I'm not giving him good direction and he's the type of horse. Hey, if I ain't got a rider, then that's it. You know, I'll drive. If you're not going to sit on my back and drive and tell me what to do, then you just sit up there and ride and I know what to do. And he'll run and he'll take you through a fence. He'll take you on a limb, knock you off. He'll do all that. He doesn't do that intentionally. They just feel comfortable and they're running. Now, I know there's people out there. No, Rick, I had a horse and every time you let him run, he'd run by a log. Horses tend to get close and everything and they've probably gotten somebody off once or twice by a log or somebody's jumped off. And they've learned that when I go by trees and I go by close things, the rider jumps off. They're not consciously thinking, I'm going to knock this rider off. They've learned through conditioning that when I've got a rider, when I get by trees, the rider jumps off. They don't have the concept to think, if I go into this limb, it's just low enough, I can get my head below it, and it'll hit the rider and knock him off. No. That's why when a horse bucks and you fall off, he thinks you got off. That's why when a horse spooks and you fall off, he thinks you got off. But if he starts connecting you getting off with spooking, bucking, or running by trees, guess what he's going to do? You've taught him to do it. Well, the wind's picking up out here. It wasn't blowing a few minutes ago. So I'm gonna take Mr. T back over to Buddy, see if I can't get him to walk lightly. Okay. Okay, see, he still wants to prance. And he's prancing because I'm not making him walk. Normally, if I was riding him, I'd be like, oh, back it up. Now I'm gonna give him direction. Now he's got both ears. He hears the tone of my voice. Drop that head. I'm sorry, boss. I'm sorry. I'm listening now. Showing respect. Okay, he must not be playing. Maybe he is talking to me. But because I keep yapping and running my mouth in his phone, he's ignoring what I say. So I have to connect what I say to my body language, to my rein control, to what I'm telling him to do. Now, when we walk off here, I'm going to give him just a light squeeze and move his reins. He should walk, but he's going to probably start prancing. Now we're walking. Head's still a little high, and I'm lowering my voice, so I'm not talking to his phone. Now we're walking, but his head's still way high. I can still feel the tension in his body, because he's got all this piss and vinegar. He just feels like a horse. He's been eating this green grass. It's nice and cool out here, and he just wants to be a horse. But now he's walking. Okay, now we're going to start trotting here again, so I'm going to back him up. Ho. Back. Back. Every time he trots, I'm going to walk him. Walk. Okay, he wants to trot. So we're going to ho. Back up. Back. After a while, he's going to connect. When I trot, I have to back up. I don't like backing up, so I'll walk. And again, I'm not holding him back, making him walk. I'm giving him loose rein so he can commit to the mistake. I want him to know that you have to walk on a loose rein. I see too many people walking their horse, and the reins are tight, and they're pulling and fighting. Back up. Back. Back. Good boy. See, Buddy's going to come up here and sees me working. So I'm surprised he hasn't. He's usually a lot more. Mr. T's talking to him. He's trying to get him. And see, I'm grabbing his rein in one hand. I'm grabbing Mr. T. Look at the head. Look at those reins. Look at the head. He's getting that head high trying to circumvent my ability to turn his head. And that's what horses do. When they know you don't know what you're doing, that's why people get big bits. Because they don't know what they're doing, so they get a pain bit. And then they can make the horse hurt even when he's got his head high. Hear that snorting? Hear that snorting? Okay, back up. Back up. I know, poor Mr. T. Dad's making him work, and he's just been a good old lazy horse. I know. So I'm going to let him eat a little bit, drop those reins. He's going to learn to stand here on a loose rein. If he wants to eat, he can eat. If he walks, he gets to back up. And again, Buddy, oh, he walked off. I don't want that. Back up. So I pick those reins up, and then I set them back down. I don't want a horse that I have to hold on the reins and make him stand still. When you see somebody holding a horse and they can't relax and they can't loosen those reins, they don't know what they're doing. They haven't trained a horse to stand on a loose rein. They've never given a horse release, so the horse thinks the only time I have to stand is when this stupid rider is pulling on my face, hurting my mouth, pulling on the reins, and yanking on me. So they get irritated. They don't enjoy, you know, that relax time, that release time. They never learn that. Oh, hell, I'm at 14:22. All right, hope that helps on Mr. T. I didn't let him get too out of control because he'd throw my ass on the ground and then I'd be posting some video with me pulling mud out of the camera. So I kind of kept him a little bit tight, letting him troll. I didn't let him play. When I put this camera up, we're going to do a few loops. And buddy will be bucking and running next to him, and that's going to be jacking him up, and I'm going to work on him paying attention to me. I don't care what buddy does. I don't care what other horses do. When I'm on my horse, he pays attention to me. He walks on a loose rein, and he listens. And if you don't work on that and you don't teach a horse that, he'll never learn it. And too many people want their horse to know what they're thinking instead of what they're doing. And we don't do the same thing as we think. That's 15 minutes. Got to go. Hope that helps. Good boy, Mr. T.